Shalom, fellow Ras Teferi, this is Wendell Malonzo. You know, on behalf of the Lion of the Tribe of Judah Society, I and I bring forth this reasoning, and we consider this day today, David conversing with Yahweh Elohim, with I and I, creator of the heavens and the earth, governor to this universe. Let us consider, and let us now open up I and I scripture to the book of 2 Samuel. Let us direct thyself over to Mi'raf Sebat, which would be the 7th chapter, and let us initiate this reasoning with the 20th verse of the 7th chapter of the book of 2 Samuel. Now this is concerning David conversing with the Almighty. And what can David say more to thee? For thou, Lord God, knowest thy servant. For thy word's sake, and according to thine own heart, hast thou done all these great things, to make thy servant know them. Wherefore, thou art great, O Lord God, for there is none like thee, neither is there any God beside thee, according to all that we have heard with our ears. And what one nation in the earth is like thy people? Even like Israel, whom God went to redeem for a people to himself, and to make him a name, and to do for you great things and terrible, for thy land before thy people, which thou redeemest to thee from Egypt, from the nations and their gods. Behold, David has asked a question to I and I, good creator, I and I, God and Father, and the question is, and what one nation in the earth is like thy people, even like Israel? You know, so let us consider, you know, Old Testament things once concealed, now revealed in the manifestation, in the living word, in the spirit of truth, in and through Jesus Christos, Geta Jesus Christos, Getachin, Metchanetachin, our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christos, Yeshua HaMashiach, now revealed, you know, in its actuality, in its practicality. And for these latter days, let us bring to the remembrance of I and I, brethren and sistren, that it is the glory of God to conceal a thing, and it is the honor of kings to seek out a matter, to search out a matter. You know, as long as I and I do diligence, you know, and prove I and I selves as men and women and children, if so be the case, you know, that need not be ashamed, that go forth as workmen, need not be ashamed, rightfully dividing the word of truth, then I and I of a surety, those things concealed in and through Jesus Christos shall be revealed to them that seek it, to seek after a matter, you know. So let us seek the answer to this question that David has made to Yahweh Elohim, for I and I trusted that David deserved an answer. And you know, we give thanks and praises to the Almighty Igziab Her, you know, Amlakachin, our God, our sustainer and supporting source, our supporting and sustaining force, the Almighty. We give thanks for having received the answer that now we can give to David and to all those that seek to learn the truth, half of the story not never told until now, these latter days, you know, in its actuality. And it is extremely important that we make known to the world the truth of the matter, so that ones can accept truth for that which is and not that which is not. So let us direct ourselves to the book of the prophets. Specifically the book of the prophet Amos, and let us direct thyself forward onto Amos chapter 9, 9th chapter, and the 7th verse. Behold, are ye not as children of the Ethiopians to me, O children of Israel? ? Said the Lord. Have not I brought up Israel out of the land of Egypt, and the Philistines from Kaphtor, and the Syrians from Kir. So behold, you know, now revealed that which was once concealed. David had a question. The question was, is there any one nation upon this earth likened to thy people, even like Israel? The answer is yes, there is. And the answer we can find in the book of the prophet Amos, Amos chapter 9, verse 7. Are ye not as the children of Ethiopians to me, O children of Israel? Yes, there is a nation likened to Israel. That nation is righteous and imperial Ethiopia, and those people are the righteous, true and faithful imperial Ethiopians. You know, those that served alongside I and thy God and Father, Edomawi, Haile Selassie, the elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, Negus Negesh, the Ethiopia, the king of kings of Ethiopia. You know, these people are likened to Israel. So yes, there is one nation upon this earth likened to Israel, even Ethiopia, imperial and righteous Ethiopia. Now care not for the events that have taken place on these, referring to modern Ethiopia, for as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. You know, we know the situation with the creeping coup in Ethiopia, how the serpent, you know, deceived the Ethiopians, once righteous, now fallen astray. But nonetheless, imperial Ethiopia was established, was preserved, and was carefully preserved, you know, surrounded by those natural mountains and natural barriers, you know, keeping pure the truth of the Almighty as a living testimony, a witness to be a testimony to truth in these latter days, you know, carefully preserved in the highlands of Ethiopia, was that one nation upon this earth that is likened to the people of the Almighty, even likened to Israel. Now Amos chapter 9 verse 7, it is Yahweh himself that declares that we are to be as the Ethiopians to him, O Israel, an example for Israel to consider. And so, you know, we proudly, we in all honor, we reveal and make known and show to those willing to see and to hear the word of truth in its fullness, you know, in its manifestation as the living truth, and nothing else can be. And it is extremely necessary that we establish this simple fact that is oftentimes ignored, well, most of the times ignored or completely just forgotten or not even considered, so that the certain people that have for long been downpressed, you know, in and through Jesus Christos in his spirit and in truth, we can exalt those who for so long have been kept down, you know, and reveal the shame that is I and I in this world community, that we may know our shame for our wrongdoings, and the chastisement of the children of Israel, the black peoples of the world, and that the word of truth may be glorified and made known and shown to the world, you know, be revealed to all those willing to receive half of the story never told until now, you know. On behalf of the Lion of the Tribe of Judah Society and all disciples within the society, women, you know, children and men, we bring forth this revelation to the world, you know, accept it for what it is, for nothing else can be. Ethiopia is that one nation upon this earth likened to the people chosen by the Most High God, Jah Rastafari, and I must also make mention that people chosen to bear the full truth is Rastafari. We're not saying that there are not other individuals out there, other camps, other churches, we could say, that don't receive a part in this, but them that have been chosen to declare the fullness of the truth and glory of the Almighty is Ras Tefri. So shalom to all the Ivem. We give thanks and praises to Igziab here. I'm La Kachin. You know, Be Jesus Christus. Getachin Metchanitachin. In and through our Lord and Savior, our cure, our medicine man, we could say, Jesus Christus, our healer. Shalom.